Hello, and my name is Brent Gullo, and this is Calvary's Corner with Calvary Baptist Church in Middleburg, Florida. I want to share another verse with you as it relates to our current situation in the country, and as many households and families are trying to make right decisions and are at various stages of this pandemic, trying to work through different circumstances and just all the complications that have gone on in our country in varying degrees and different circumstances with that. I want to be an encouragement to you and give you a pretty common verse, but maybe something that's sometimes a bit overlooked, and maybe you can apply it to your heart and maybe meditate on it a little bit to bring some comfort and some stability to your day-to-day routine. Psalm 46, verse 10 says, "Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth." And oftentimes I've seen the first half of this verse in department stores. I've seen it on publications. Oftentimes different retailers carry this, and they paint the first half on plaques and they put it in cards, and it's a great source of encouragement. Be still and know that I am God. But oftentimes, I don't know that I've ever seen the last half of the verse with the first half of the verse out in public. And oftentimes it's not even referred to as far as my experience is concerned. But I think the last half of the verse gives great power and extra emphasis to the first half of the verse. God said, "I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth." And he doesn't stumble. He doesn't stutter. He has decided this prior to any of us being here. The God of eternity has decided from eternity past to eternity all the way in the future, "I will be exalted among the heathen, and I will be exalted in the earth." It's almost like if he says that, then therefore, be still and know that I am God. A great life verse for me, verses is Job 38. Job 38, first few verses here. The Lord answered Job out of the whirlwind and said, "Who is this that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge? Gird up now thy loins like a man, for I will demand of thee. And answer thou me, where wast thou when I laid the foundations of the earth? Declare if thou hast understanding." And the older I get, the more I realize I don't know. And Job had gone through a very difficult time, to say the least. And God confronts him a little bit and said, "Where were you when I created the earth? I'm in charge. I'm not worried about anything. Tell me, who is this that darkeneth counsel by words without knowledge?" The Bible has a lot to say about speaking few words. And something that can contribute to our stability is just knowing that God is in control. It's hard to be still. There's enough noise in society. It's hard for people to be still and to be quiet. The Bible says, "Study to be quiet," in the book of Thessalonians. It's hard for people to be quiet. There's media, there's entertainment, there's always some gadget in front of us, a television, a cell phone. Always something to stimulate our thinking or to entertain us. But when we get quiet, when we have to make a very good effort nowadays to unplug things and get away, it can be a scary time to confront your heart, and people don't like that. But for the believer, when we get alone and we let God work on our heart for a while, and we think about that God already said, "He's going to be exalted among the heathen. He's already going to be exalted in the earth." When I want God's glory more than anything else, that's probably a time, the best chance that I have to be still and to know that he is God. Let's examine our lives. Let's remember where we were when he found us. As we get older, let's make sure let's take enough time with God to be humbled, to realize there's a lot we don't know, and let's spend enough time with God in the stillness for him to calm us down so we can approach our families, our own personal life, society, our churches, with a calmness and really know on a heart level and understand what it is to be still and to know that He is God. Thank you for your time. God bless you and your family. And let's keep going forward for God. Amen. Thank you.